the scanner with a head on. We were far away though. I think the helicopter landed already. Too bad we didn't get here on time for the helicopter. Bet you we just barely missed it too. With the settings yet, because it was sitting down.
We just saw someone get taken out of the AV system. We didn't get here in time enough for the other ones, but I know we know that helicopter landed. So it was a head on, right?
That's what I heard. It was confirmed that there was one unconscious, unresponsive.
Yeah. Oh, you felt that? When that UPS truck passed you? The way the bridge bounced? Yeah, and it's always to log into your...
Yeah, you're okay to do that. I have 15 gigabytes of it. I don't need it.
We'll set it up after, you know, see how it goes.
Yeah, it's okay. I just want to pray it's not going to be good.
Not sure. There was someone very critical. But, I mean, you can see on the cars, there's a big damage, you know.
Yeah.
There's actually four cars. There's these two, there's a truck over there, and then there's other two on the side. But those didn't get that much damage, but the truck is pretty bad, too.
Yeah.
And then these two.
You know what, this part of 215, when it's raining,
bad.
It is horrible.
I mean, they were saying it was a one-way head on, so
someone's
out. No, actually someone was coming in the one way.
That's
what we're thinking is that the gray one over here, yeah. So, I'm not sure if it came in for the 6200 south entrance.
But that's a pretty close
to the line. Yes, it is. Have a good day. I don't think there's anyone in there. But I'm not sure.
Oh my goodness. Oh wow. Yeah, I took one of those drivers that we think is a piece of shit. You know, this is a king. Thank you.
someone in there, but I don't think so.
Park on the side of the street and come back. It's just a young girl too, you know. origin of this UHP vehicle. Very nice, polite. Family member. No, she has a clipboard. She has a clipboard.
Sad, we are one of our UDOT incident management team members called out the crash first, came upon the crash first at the same moment we were being called at the wrong way. So the crash happened before we ever got a call. Like I said, a few minutes of freeway speed.
And traffic on eastbound is maybe shut down, obviously.
Correct.
Expected to be for a couple more hours or so.
Yeah, well, we're working on shooting the scene with our evidence collection technique using laser distance measurement. We also still do the old-fashioned measuring tape with a needle meter. But we'll just for a matter of redundancy to get a good amount of data that we can reconstruct the crash from, we'll also fly a drone here shortly. So once that's done, those data collection techniques, then we'll be open to freeway at that time.
And you find yourself in the
Yeah, we have four vehicles involved here.
Oh, four vehicles.
Yep.
And two trucks up there.
Yeah, so there's a work van and a black truck up there. Everyone was single occupant drivers, solo occupant drivers in each vehicle. The driver of the van was the only one not transported to the hospital. They're just lying. It's a little shaken up after being involved in an incident like this, but otherwise, didn't need to go to the hospital. Okay. Looks like we're to a point where we can get started. So, Sergeant Nick Street, are you good? Nick Street, Utah Highway Patrol, NCA-STREET, or Public Information Officer.
So what happened on here yesterday?
Here you had an individual driving the gray car that you see behind us. It's a gray Ford Fusion, or kind of a charcoal colored Ford Fusion. But got on the freeway wrong way. Back, I think, the 39-3300 south off-ramp from northbound 215. That's a few miles up the road. It's 80-year-old, or female in her 80s that got on the freeway wrong way. Came down, took that black Tacoma pickup that you see behind me. And also a work van there. Probably, introduce some dynamic scenarios with all vehicles trying to maintain control, but yeah, before they could regain control, the one-way vehicle impacted the gold Ford Taurus that you see down there that was being driven by a female in her 20s. She did not survive the crash.
So tell me a little bit about what happened there. Apparently she got on quite a ways up there then?
Yeah, at least 3-4 miles up the road. We didn't get a call. We got a call for the crash from one of the UDOT incident management team members before it was ever dispatched that there was a one-way driver. So the timing of this kind of stinks for us being able to intercept that before the individual took it.
What can you share with me as far as you understand the driver just didn't, she didn't maybe know what she was doing when she was going on the wrong way, or what do you think?
Yeah, at this time we don't necessarily suspect impairment. We'll gather evidence to rule that out, but we believe that with the age of the individual that entered the freeway wrong way, being in their 80s, it may be a situation where they were confused as to how to properly get on the interstate.
And really no indication that she was doing this on purpose or anything like that. Maybe just got on the wrong way.
Right, yeah, no indication at this time to say anything else other than likely confused being on the interstate. No, the wrong way driver? No, the wrong way driver's been transported to the hospital, from what I understand, had a pulse and was somewhat coherent before leaving.
Your reaction when you see something like this and come across something like this?
You know, it's awful, it's one of those things you work hard with our UDOT partners to engineer roadways so that runway driving incidents like these don't happen. They can be so catastrophic as they are, in this situation. There's a lot we can do and maybe more we can do, and we'll evaluate that, but at the same time there are those hard conversations that we might need to have with our loved ones to give them the hint that maybe it might be time to hang up their driving privilege. And in this circumstance maybe that could have avoided this situation, but without knowing all the details we may never know. But if you are a person that has an elderly relative or friend that is still getting behind the wheel, that might be at that point where it's a little scary for the rest of us, please have that conversation with them. And it might be for the best.
What are the laws or rules when can you take away the license?
Well, hopefully it doesn't come to a situation like this, but law enforcement does have the opportunity to submit letters to the driver license division when they encounter drivers who maybe aren't displaying proper behavior as they're driving down the roadway. Me personally, I ran into numerous situations where either people were confused on the side of the road, not quite sure where they were, probably shouldn't have been behind the wheel in the first place, but those are situations where I'd submit that individual's driver license number to the driver license division for a medical evaluation. The decision ultimately gets made by medical providers as to whether that person should continue to drive.
I kind of touched on this, but is there a frustration that no one is able to call this?
My guess is people are trying to call it in. Like I said, though, there's just minutes between where they got on and if they were at freeway speed, where they would have impacted and killed this young woman in her 20s. But in that time, it takes time for those phone calls to be made and 911 operators to get it to the appropriate agency if it doesn't directly go to highway patrol. And sometimes it does, and so we can react a little faster. But in this circumstance, the call came out that the crash had occurred before we ever got a call that there was a wrong way driver.
We kind of talked before, how long do you think this is closed down for?
The freeway is going to be closed down for, I'd say, a couple more hours. And the closure is between 2000 East and 6200 South on 215 eastbound. All other roadways are open, but just avoid the area for the next couple hours, maybe 3 hours, between 2000 East and 6200 South.
Again, guys, this is a sad situation. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Love you guys. Take care. And don't forget to subscribe to Salt Lake City Utah Cop Watch.